show you a very easy way to make lavender bags. We've picked lots of lavender. We've bought some lovely old-fashioned handkerchiefs. So you take a handkerchief, you take some lavender, and you take the four corners of the handkerchief, like this, and then you fold them in, like that, and then take a piece of lovely embroidery thread we've got here, and then tie it round. Lavender is both calming and it's also insecticidal, which means that it'll keep moths out of your wardrobe if you keep lavender in it. Do you want to make one, Emily?
Mm-hmm.
You can make one each. I think you need, of your hand, I think you need probably 3 handfuls to fill the bag. Or 2.5. Then I'll take some as well. Two handfuls for me. Which colour are you going to have? Pink. I think I'll have a blue one. There you go. You've got a long one. So you just have to twist it round more times. These are lovely Christmas presents, and in fact, when I went to the herbal school, one of my fellow students, called Bendel, he made lavender bags, or little lavender pillows, that he sold. And I had mine, I've still got mine, and it's over 20 years ago, and it's still smelling of beautifully of lavender. So. You can make the lavender bags at the end of the summer when the lavender is dry and beautiful, and then you can use them for Christmas presents or birthday presents all year round until you run out. There's another one. Oh, you've got a lot of twisting around to do. So I'll make another one while I'm waiting for you to finish twisting. So take 2 corners up and 2 corners up. So all 4 corners meet in the middle. And then as you collect it in your hand, make sure that the shorter corners come in as well. And are above where you're going to tie it, because otherwise the bag will leak. I think it's very beautiful when it's tied lots of times around. I'm just finished tying mine. You can also make lavender bags with any other pure cotton, fine enough to keep the dust in, because it does get a bit dusty. So there we are, lavender bags.